since the launch of space tourism, people have become increasingly fascinated with the idea of venturing beyond the Earth's atmosphere.
Well, a new docuseries, Among the Stars, is giving viewers unprecedented access to the world of NASA. And our reporter Britt Cohen caught up with a man at the heart of the mission.
But it gives people the chance to see all of the things that go on for a space flight besides riding the rocket and putting on a spacesuit. That's what's very visible, but there's so many aspects of space flight, and particularly the training, that people don't ever get to see.
For 377 days of his life, Navy SEAL turned NASA astronaut Chris Cassidy called space home.
The data we get from this could shape the future of space exploration.
It'll be my third trip to space and could well be my last.
Any given mission can end in a catastrophic way.
Chris is one of the most capable astronauts we have.
With cameras on both Earth and the International Space Station, now we're getting to see an up-close look at Chris's final critical mission.
Your team was also tasked with repairing a very important piece of equipment. Tell us what the whole mission entailed.
On the space station, there are hundreds of experiments that are put up there by researchers and scientists from around the world. And one of those was this very complex physics experiment that looks for the origins of the universe. And it's on the outside of the space station, and the cooling system on that device called the Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer was breaking. We needed to fix it. We started to train and prepare to get ready to do it, and the viewers will see in the show there was some ups and downs in the process.
Let's go do a spacewalk.
Jane, good morning to everybody in Houston. Great to be with you.
Chris has had to perform several heart-stopping spacewalks during his NASA career, which can be both exhilarating and unpredictable.
How do you describe the feeling when you're out there?
Oh my gosh, the feeling is unlike any other. The best way I've found to relay the sense of going outside the space station is if you go to the very top of a skyscraper, you know, the tallest building in Sydney, and put your toes over the edge, and you have no handrail, and you're looking down. And that's what it's like when you open that hatch of the space station and you climb out hand over hand to start the job. We spent so many hours training in a large pool that the actual hands-on work feels very familiar. It's the surroundings that you're in that are all new to you, because you can never go to space to practice it. You have to just do it.
So much larger than the me of life.
Now it's interesting because space tourism is really taking off. William Shatner just became the oldest person to go into space. What do you think about regular people, average Joes, going up there and seeing it for themselves?
Well, I think if every person on the planet had 5 minutes in front of the window of a spacecraft, the world would be a better, more peaceful place. And you realize it's a fragile spaceship for everybody. And viewing it from the window gives you that perspective. So I think I'm all for it. The more people that can get up there, the better. And if you want to strap yourself to a rocket with fuel on it and blast off, I'm right there cheering you, and I'm all for everybody to do it.
What are you most excited to see in the future of space and the future of NASA?
Ultimately, I cannot wait to see somebody walk on Mars. I think that'll be so cool. I'll be an old guy watching from my couch. It'll be a couple decades away, I'm sure. I find that pretty exciting. I can't wait for that.
We're always looking for where we came from, the origins of the universe. We just don't know what we're gonna find.
Among the Stars is out now on Disney+. Go and check it out.
Very cool.